Welcome to V8 Nation, talking all things motorsport with Rick Kelly and Paul Dumbrell.
Hello everybody, right around Australia, welcome to V8 Nation, the world of motorsport. We are about to get stuck into the boys are in Townsville this weekend, V8 Supercar action. We're going to talk a lot about that and a lot about what has been happening in the last week, including Casey Stoner. A little bit of luck needed in the world of motorsport, and he got some last week. Jorge Lorenzo going down on the first corner. We're going to talk to Grant all about that from speedcafe.com. We've got a competition, a lovely pair of Mac boots to give away. Can't wait for that one. And make sure you are following us on Twitter at V8 Nation and liking our stuff on Facebook, facebook.com/V8Nation. As always, we do it all thanks to Spitwater. Spitwater High Pressure Cleaners. Over 30 years, been doing a wonderful job, the High Pressure Cleaners. If you need to know more, jump on their website, spitwater.com.au. No Rick Kelly, but Paul Dumbrell is here. PD, welcome to you.
Oh, thank you very much, Cam. It's been a big couple of months, really. It's good to see Rico not coming here this week. I reckon I've shown up here more than what he has over the last 2 months.
I'm with you.
Do you reckon?
I'm with you now.
I think we need to change the intro. Yeah. Can we do that? Can you actually do that?
I can. Okay. I can.
You're not going to? I feel some trepidation.
Well, you know what? Because the only thing is, I had this exact conversation last week with Rick Kelly and Michael Caruso. Caruso trying to bump you off your perch at V8 Nation. He's wandered in for one show. He did a very nice job and we appreciate it, but he's no Paul Dumbrell. And he said, I think it's time to change the intro. And I said, mate, if you hang around for more than 2 hours, I think we will think about it. But give me 7 days.
Mm-hmm.
Let me think about it. People can let us know on Facebook, facebook.com/V8Nation.
What should the new name of the show be?
Yeah.
V8 Nation with who?
Yes.
I reckon you should put that question on Facebook.
And should your name
put it
be,
to the people.
Should your name be first?
Well, I do want to bring that up. All after right. 12 months, I think our ratings would double.
Yeah, okay.
If it was
double.
Paul and Rick from, rather than Rick and Paul.
From 2 to 4.
Yeah, absolutely.
If you're first. All right, well, we'll check all that out. Facebook.com/V8Nation. If you've got a little bit of advice for the naming of the show and intro, it's always going to stay V8 Nation.
Absolutely. You can't go, but it's a great name.
It is.
Great name.
Paul Dumbrell suggesting his name should be first.
I actually came up with the name, actually.
Did you really?
Hutchie and I were at the Mount Erica pub.
Oh, here we go.
On one fateful Saturday afternoon.
Trust me,
he did not throw me a tip for a win. I won't give you that much advice. But yes, we came up with a great name, V8 Nation.
Well, it is.
Put the seed to what V8 Nation is today.
There you go, facebook.com/V8Nation. Make sure you like us on Facebook. Plenty of prizes to win, including the wonderful Mac boots that if you are looking at our YouTube video.
They're first time in this week. I haven't seen them before.
No, they were here last week, mate.
That's right. Sorry, I wasn't here last week. Sorry.
I tell you what, they're bulldog tough and they are the best boot on the market. Macboots.com.au. Check it out. And before you and I, PD, get out of here, today we are going to give a pair of Mac boots away and we're running it for the next 6 weeks. Facebook is where you got to go. Let us know, boots and all, who has impressed you in the world of motorsport in 2012. Already got some wonderful entries and one of those entries is going to win that person a pair of Mac boots. So we're going to get to that very, very shortly. Let's get to what's happening this weekend though, because Townsville's the location for V8 Supercar round and I know you're going to be involved in a small way even though you're not racing. Tell us a little bit about the track.
It's another street track, but it's actually sort of a part of the track is actually purpose-built. So a number of years ago when they first launched Townsville, they actually did some development and made some of the infield part of the track purpose-built. There are some roads, but it's not a commercial road. But the main straight is actually one of the main streets through the back of Townsville. So it's quite unique. It's actually a reasonably fast track. It's got a very, very fast turn one and a couple of quite strong, hard-braking turn two and turn three as well. But overall, love racing there. It was quite an enjoyable track. It's one of those tracks where you can be quite aggressive over the curbs. They've got good curbs. They're quite low, so you can fire over the curbs. And you see a number of guys trying to sort of shortcut the track. And it's right on the fine line of if you take too much curb, you then sort of fire over the track and it doesn't actually settle the car early enough. But no, it's seen some good winners last year. Team Vodafone actually had a camouflaged car last year, which they obviously did quite well up there. But you know, you can't really put it past FPR or 888 this year. They've been the form team, four or five drivers from those two teams, and it's going to be very interesting to see from the other side of the track this weekend.
We're going to get stuck into some predictions from people out there on Facebook World as to what they think will happen over this weekend. Just run through your involvement. I know you're up there. I know you're jumping in a car. When and what exactly do you do?
So I'm doing two practice sessions. So how the rules are and the series are today, on the Friday of every race meeting, there is a half an hour practice session for the co-drivers only.
Yep.
So and there's only four of those race meetings throughout the year where the co-drivers drive only. Then there's three practice sessions. The first practice session, there's four sessions. So the first one is co-drivers only. Yep. The second one is anyone who's outside the top 15 in the championship or co-drivers. So, for example, Jamie Winkup, he can't drive that because he's leaving the championship.
But you
now.
Can.
But I can because I'm outside of the top 15 and I'm a co-driver. But if you're a full-time driver and you're outside the top 15 of the championship, you can actually also drive that session as well, or you're a co-driver. Mm-hmm. And then the last two sessions are just for the main drivers only. So I think I'll be pulled up stumps for the day from about, 2 o'clock or around that, and I'll watch Jamie hopefully, tear the place apart and be on P1 for Friday's practice.
What do you think about the new qualifying and the new practice rules? Now, you just touched on that they get everyone gets two practices as full-time drivers, but the people outside the 15 are getting that extra one in to have a look at the track and work on different things. Is it a good or a bad thing?
I think what it's trying to do is help those guys who are maybe, the new people or people who aren't travelling that well, that extra little bit of track time. But it probably doesn't change.
This isn't juniors, though. This isn't junior karting, PD. This is an elite. This is elite sport. This is the creme la creme. And, if you're outside the top 15, it's not because you've just wandered in. Oh, and there are rookies, would appreciate this type of extra practice, I guess. But someone like Rick Kelly. Is a perfect example. Yep. He's not here, so we'll bring it up and have a crack at him.
Have a slack at him.
He's struggling. There's no doubt. He's put his hand up. They're tinkering and whatever, and things aren't going right yet in 2012. Yep, sure. There could be an opportunity for him to actually get an extra practice session in. The dude's been around for 10 years and has won a championship.
And that's the thing. I had a similar point last year where we had a shocking start to the year and we were sort of outside the top 15 for the remainder of the year. So I got to some tracks. And when you're going to a track like Philippine or somewhere where everyone's been for their whole life, it sort of does make a big difference. But when you go to tracks like, which are very technical tracks or street tracks, it's a big advantage. And, you get your eye in earlier, you get to use a different set of tyres. So going back to the sessions, the co-driver gets to use a set of tyres which isn't used in the last two sessions. So if you're not in the top 15, you get another set of tyres which you can use for there. So you get an extra practice session, you get an extra run on different set of tyres. So it is a big advantage if you're one of the high calibre drivers who aren't in the battle for the championship.
I'm happy for the V8 Supercars to make a rule. Not that I have anything to do with it.
I'll write this down, mate, and just send it up to Queensland.
If you say you've been in the category of the class 3 years or younger or shorter, so if you're in your first, second or third years and you're just starting to acclimatise into being a full-time V8 supercar driver, possibly they allow an extra practice. But I think outside the top 15, there's so many varying factors where people just might be struggling for whatever reason, and they're getting a little bit of extra play. I'm just not sure.
You're a big AFL fan, aren't you?
I am.
How much practice do the AFL players get a week?
Oh, well, they're almost on the track each and every day.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how much practice do V8 drivers get?
Yeah, but my point is that everybody should get the same amount of practice. Then the AFL is not saying, all right, Gold Coast, Greater West Sydney, Melbourne. Okay, you guys aren't travelling any
what
good.
What about so the clubs training where they ask the veterans to come back later than their rookies?
Yeah, but that's a little bit different because that is actually a club decision.
I actually think it's actually in the bargaining agreement.
But if the AFL, but they're not saying. Everybody's on the same role. Everyone's on the same level footing. They're not saying, all right, hang on, Gold Coast, Melbourne, you're struggling, right? Western Bulldogs, team I support, you're struggling. So you can have an extra training session on Friday, but no one else. If you're in the top eight, you can't train Friday. You can't wander into the ground. Do you know what I mean?
I know I'm right, but I think I see your point.
I understand what you're saying. Yeah.
No, it is tough. I see what you're saying. And someone who was a benefit of it last year, that was a big advantage.
Yep.
And even more so, when you're a team of two, three or four cars, I was in the bottom of the 15 in the championship. Mm-hmm. So in my practice session, I had the two other engineers from the other cars. They were looking over my data. Mm. So they were getting an advantage. Yeah. So it actually, what it was trying to do is help the lower teams and the people I'm performing. It didn't really do that. It really just helped the teams up the front, which was great. So I see your point, but I think we probably should move on.
It's elite sport. I think everyone should be on level footing, and I'm not sure it does that. But going forward, how are you finding in the car, mate? Because we haven't actually caught up a bit. I was away for a couple of weeks. You've been away for a couple of weeks. You've been in the car a few times. How are you feeling as the time rapidly approaches that you are getting in and having a race?
I'm actually quite excited. I've had a fair bit on the personal and business front over the last 6 months. So I've done the two drives in the car previously, which have been quite good. And we've felt comfortable in the car at the Phillip Island racetrack, and then also at the test day at Willowbank in Queensland a couple of weeks later. But it's going to be good to get up there. It's been a 2 or 3 weeks since I've been in the car since then as well. So really just happy to actually get into the actual racing part of the year, because it's not far away. So if Sandown is, I think, the second week of September this year, and Bathurst, October, it's going to be really, really exciting, and can't wait to get there.
Has it renewed your love for the sport? Not saying you lost it, but obviously when you're a full-time driver and you've got so much other stuff on, it can sometimes be taken for granted. Have you, stepping back in what will end up being around 9 months watching the other people race, do you think it's renewed your love and your passion to jump back in the car come second week of September?
The actual driving part of racing, I miss immensely, and it was one of probably the hardest things to actually get away. It's all the other stuff, which I loved, all the PR and, you know, going to schools and doing all that stuff, but it just took a lot of time, and I was a little bit time poor at that time. So the racing part and the actual driving, going to a test day and doing 20 or 30 laps, it's actually quite exciting. It's actually, you know, gets back to why you got into motor racing. But no, it is. I think certainly next year might be the point where I sit back and go, do you know what? I sort of really, really do miss that, and whether or not it was the right decision. But I'm happy with the decision I made.
You're still young, Peter. Plenty
of
time.
I'm 30 this year, so... You might actually get an invite to the 30th,
Might
not.
Hey, quickly, I know RK is not here, so I'm gonna bring this up, and I want your professional opinion. You touched on so much extracurricular stuff you have to do when you're a driver, and no one, everyone enjoys doing it, but so many people are time poor, as you said, and it just adds that little bit. Do you think Rick's got so much on being a owner of a team? He's got, they're working on the Nissan thing. Mm-hmm. Do you think it's affecting his performance as a driver, or do you think at the very least it couldn't be helping? Could it?
But that's what they've done. They've owned and run their own team. So whether or not they're dealing with Nissan and building new cars, they would have been doing the same thing anyway. So whether or not Nissan came in, they had to build new cars. So
do you think Rick would be going better if he was just a driver and not an owner?
Rick and Toyota are the most successful team owner and drivers.
Mm. Yeah, no doubt.
So if he was just an employee of the same team, if he's got the same equipment, he would have been doing the same job.
Good point.
If he was at Triple Eight, would he have won races, more races? Well, absolutely would have. But there's as much chance of Kelly Racing unlocking what they've missed, you know, in the car that they've built now with the car of the future. Because it's a level playing field. All teams have got a new crack of the cherry. So they, you know, you might have, you know, Kelly Racing, which is Nissan Racing now, be the leading team next year. You might have Dick Johnson Racing. You might have Gary Rogers. It might not be Triple Eight, you know, and FPR. They've finally got to the pinnacle, and they've got to do it all again. Yes. Like, where, you know, if you're at the top, you get a couple of years run at it. But, no, it's going to be a really interesting year to watch the racing next year.
I asked those questions. Rick and I had a discussion off air last week a little bit about this year, and no doubt he's frustrated, but... Tell you what, I'm looking forward to seeing how they go next year, because you can just sense his excitement and looking forward to the whole class's excitement in particular. And I'm not sure if we've spoken about this, but the lure of Texas, which is happening next year, and then possibly Mexico the week after, PD, is something I think it's going to really ram home to you.
I'll be over there in board shorts and singlet getting a suntan.
Yeah, you will be there. We've got to get to a break. We've got some predictions from people off the Facebook we're going to talk about next, facebook.com/V8Nation. We'll get stuck into that.
Daniel's son's got the best one of the day, I reckon.
He has. And our Mac Boots competition, where you can win a pair of Mac Boots. They're bulldog tough boots, and make sure you check out our YouTube page as well, because PD's had his hands all over the Bulldog Tough Mac Boots, and it looks very, very nice. MacBoots.com.au. A quick break. Plenty more V8 Nation. No Rick Kelly, but Paul Dumbrell's here, and he tells me that's all that matters.
This is V8 Nation with Rick Kelly and Paul Dumbrell.